I was on a red carpet with her and I froze up. I think my photos from that red carpet are incredibly awkward. Hey, this is Jenna Ortega and this is my Fangirl Shortlist. Definitely my mother. I know that may seem like a cliche answer, but my mom truly is the greatest woman I've ever known. She's incredibly strong and hardworking and very passionate and so loving. And I don't know, there's not another one like her. And I'm very, very blessed. Oh, any girl band? Ooh, I don't know, maybe like the Ronettes? Like, I can't think of a current one. I don't know, maybe them. I don't know if this is true. This is just the first one that comes to my mind. The first one that comes to my mind is probably Marla from Fight Club. I think she's cool. Let's see. Well, I could do like a not basic, but I could do a very well-known answer. I could be like Gloria Steinem, who's like, you know, one of the most visible leaders in the women's movement in the 60s or 70s. Or there's actually, I'm reading this book right now, Feminism and Nationalism in the Third World. And I don't know, I think she has really incredible things to say about intersectionality and just being a feminist and whatever it may be, but she's an educator in Sri Lanka. And I think that she's very eloquent and very well put and just so knowledgeable. So if I could be her for a day, I just want to see what that life is like and just get to know her better. Well, it's been incredibly important, especially being a person of color trying to make it in an industry where initially diversity wasn't really pushed or wasn't really an important matter, I guess I would say. Also being surrounded, I mean, there's 8 people in my intermittent family and 5 of those people are women. So I think growing up in a household full of really powerful, strong women who work really hard, I think that I've always had such an appreciation for women and all that they do, and I'm proud to be one. Oh, this is a hard one. Maybe Saoirse Ronan. I think Saoirse Ronan is really cool. Or Viola Davis. Or I could even do Kathy Bates. I don't know, I'm all over the place, but I did meet Oprah once. I was on a red carpet with her and I froze up. I think my photos from that red carpet are incredibly awkward because you could see the tension in my body, but then also she bumped into me at the after party and apologized, and I didn't say anything in return, which is probably really awkward to me, but what an experience. She walks into a room, you just get chills. Like, you don't even have to see her walk in and you just know that Oprah Winfrey is in this room right now. Weirdest place I've been spotted? I don't know, I think it might be a common, this might be a common like, oh, wasn't expecting it here situation, but in the stall of a bathroom. I remember I was just trying to pee and somebody knocked on my door and they asked for a photo and I was like, can you do this when I'm done? but I think that that's probably like the strangest or most random request. I mean, Megan Thee Stallion is just what a woman. But I also really love, I love SZA. So anytime a SZA song comes on, like the album Control is a really great one. I don't know. I think I put way too much pressure on myself and I'm incredibly hard on myself. It's literally as simple as just be easy on yourself. And the only reason why I say that is because it's, as somebody who constantly overthinks and overanalyzes everything that I do and, you know, stress myself out over the most minor details that really aren't important. I think at the end of the day, it's just important to take it easy. Everything will be all right. I get really bad anxiety. So I think when I start to stress out and get really anxious, it's just like, it's gonna be fine. Thank you so much for checking out my Fangirl Shortlist. Be sure to watch Yes Day on Netflix, out now.